In this video, I'll talk about the effects of temperature on solubility and then walk through an example where we are given the solubility levels of a certain substance and then determine how much can be dissolved in a certain amount of water at a given temperature. So we're told that the solubility of KNO3, that's potassium nitrate, is 155 grams per 100 grams of water at 75 degrees Celsius and 38.0 grams at 25 degrees Celsius. So at the warmer temperature water, we can dissolve more of this KNO3. And that makes sense to us because you've probably dissolved sugar or salt in water. And when you heat it up, it can dissolve faster. We'll talk at the end here about dissolving gases in liquids like in soda. But first, let's tackle this problem. What mass of KNO3 will crystallize out of solution if exactly 100 grams of its saturated solution at 75 degrees Celsius are cooled to 25 degrees Celsius? So we are starting with 75 degrees Celsius. And we start with this total mass of 100 grams. Now, that 100 grams includes both the KNO3 plus the water. So what we're going to do here is determine how much of the KNO3 is initially present and how much water is initially present. So at 75 degrees, color coding it, red for hot, I'll go to blue for cooling down to 25 degrees. At 75 degrees, the solubility is 155 grams per 100 grams of water. Keeping the unit straight across, we've got the solute in the numerator, KNO3. We have X. We don't know how much KNO3, that's our unknown, how much KNO3 in the total 100 grams. Now, this is 100 minus X. And let's put a code here. That's the grams of water. Right? Because we should have the same ratio. 155 to 100 should be the same ratio of grams of solute, grams of KNO3, to grams of water. And the reason 100 minus X is the grams of water is because we start with 100 grams total of the solution minus the amount of the KNO3 that is dissolved in there. And that'll give us the grams of water. Okay. Running through this quickly, to solve this, I'm going to cross multiply and I get 15500 minus 155x equals 100x, and I'm going to write 15500 equals 255x. I'm going to put the x over here, and x equals, on that part, 60.78 grams of KNO3. That's when it's hot. Now, the water is 100 minus X. I'll put that in green over here. Water, grams of water is 100 minus 60.78. And so that equals 39.22 grams of water. Now, we say that the KNO3 will crystallize out of the solution, and that's true, but we will still have the same amount of water. So when we cool this down, some of the KNO3 will crystallize out, but we will still have 39.22 grams of water. So it's cooling down. I'm changing to blue. At 25 degrees, we have this new ratio, 38 to 100, 38.0. We'd have that for our significant digits, significant figures. 38 to 100 is the ratio. And now the question is, how much grams? I'll use Y for the variable here. Y, and that is going to be our grams of KNO3. And over grams of water, well, again, that's going to stay the same. So that's just 39.22. Same ratio, whether we have 100 grams of water or 39.22 grams of water. The ratio will stay the same, but the y is going to change. I'm just going to jump to the answer on this one. Y equals, when it is cool, we only have 14.90 grams of KNO3. I should say still dissolved, still in solution. Whereas we had 60.78 grams of the KNO3 originally dissolved. So, can you jump? Can you make the leap? Here's what we're doing. How much will crystallize out? Well, if we had 60.78 grams at 75 degrees and we still had 14.9 grams dissolved in there at 25 degrees, then the difference of these two numbers, the difference of these, will give us the amount that crystallizes out. So real quickly over here, we've got 60.78 minus 14.90. And I'll round now because we should use three significant digits. And we come to a 45.9 grams of KNO3 crystallizing out. I hope that was helpful. As always, if it was, please consider liking this video or sharing it with a friend.